me close through the night. Don't let me go, I'll be alright. Touch my soul and hold it tight. I've been waiting all my life. Love won't scar your young heart. Just take my hand. 'Cause I was made for loving you. Even though we may be hopeless, cars just passing through.
Every boy's screaming,
I don't know what we should do. All I know is, darling, I was made for loving you. Please don't go. I've been waiting so long. Even though we may be hopeless, hearts just passing through. Every bone screaming, I don't know what we should do. All I know is, darling, I was made for love.
Nathan Josiah Sapia, take this woman whom you now hold by the hand to be your true and wedded wife, and do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses to love, cherish, honor, and protect her, forsaking all others, cleave to her and only her until death shall separate you?
Do you,
Chloe Lane Bell, take this man whom you now hold by the hand to be your true and wedded husband? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses to love, cherish, honor, and obey him, forsaking all others, cleave to him, and only him until death shall separate you?
All right. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. Chloe Lane, this is my vow to you, to give you my life, to cherish you and rejoice in Jesus with you. You have been with me through some of the best moments and without a doubt the worst. You are what kept me standing at times, and I will never forget something you said to me. After Dad passed, you asked me the most important question of both of our lives. You asked me how I needed you to love me. What a woman, right? Your thoughtfulness and selfless love are things I get to enjoy for the rest of my life, and I'm so grateful that I get an opportunity to reciprocate that love.
Book of Ephesians, it says, "For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God has prepared in advance for us to do." It also says, "In him, you too are being built together to become a dwelling place in which God lives by his Spirit." Our marriage has a meaning and a purpose. He has blessed us so that we might bless others by being ambassadors of his word. Together and in unity with Christ, we are much stronger than as individuals. I look forward to the ways that God will use our marriage. Today, not only do I adopt the Sapien name, but also the legacy that comes with it. I see such great leadership and integrity in you, and I feel so undeserving that God is gracious enough to grant you my husband. I vow to be a woman who will crown you with encouragement and kind words. I promise to pray for you daily and continue to learn new things about you. I will be unified to you, loving you respectfully and unconditionally. My hope for our marriage is to lean on God for wisdom, to hold fast to each other during difficulties, and to live a joy-filled life together. You are the person that I have been gifted by God, and where I belong is with you.
They say love is more precious than gold. It can't be bought and it can't be sold.